I used these display easels from the Dollar Tree to create the frame for this wreath, and then what I wanted to do is actually take them apart, and I just kind of slid them right out of one another, and then I took a pair of wire cutters and popped off the little hinges. They do come off really easily, so be careful there are no children or pets around because they can go flying. I took them outside and spray painted the one side, and the same with these cute little deer. I spray painted them with a caramel latte color, and then I'm E6000ing every little point that is going to connect here together to create an outer frame. Now, I didn't spray paint both sides. I was actually happy that I didn't do that, and I was able to choose the side that I preferred in color. I actually chose the side that wasn't spray painted, so it kind of has this darker tint to it, and I really liked the way it looked. So again, just E6000ing all the points and maybe applying a little bit of pressure on where you're finding that they're lifting or, you know, not connecting properly, and then leaving it for a couple days. The thing you want to do is lay out your snowflakes and arrange them and your deer in the positions you would like or have an idea that you would like. So my deer is going in the bottom right hand corner. I'm removing all the strings from the Christmas ornament snowflakes, and then I'm going to E6000 every intercept that it makes with any other snowflake or even the plastic frame, because you want everything to be fixed together. So I also removed, you know, the little circles that hold the string. I cut those off with a dull pair of scissors. My scissors were not sharp at all, and they came off really, really easily. So if you don't want those showing, I mean, they're not that obvious, but I just thought it would look nicer and cleaner without them on. I will E6000 every little corner, and then I've actually applied a little bit of weight. You see the little bucket or a little pail, and I'll put a bowl, and just so that everything is kind of gluing down nice and secure. And I'm going to leave this for a couple days before I touch it. The little deer is also going to be E6000 down at the corner. I've applied E6000 on its body, and then anywhere again that it intercepts or connects with the plastic frame. Even the little hoof got a ton of E6000 glue. And then it was sliding, so I just applied a little bit of pressure, and I actually used my scissors. So I left this piece to dry for about 2 days. I wanted to make sure the E6000 glue was completely dry. And now I've taken some of the command hooks from the Dollar Tree, and they have a super sticky back. I was super impressed, but if you want to be very super sure that they're not going to slide off the frame, just E6000 the two pieces there with the upside down hooks. Attach some wire that you can find actually in the tools department, floral, or even the craft aisle. So I'm just using some jewelry wire, and I'm going to attach it here upside down on the two command hooks. And then what I'm going to do is use one command hook on my door, which I'm going to stick the right side up, I guess, and have it hanging there. So once I hung my frame up, I realized it was lopsided. Of course, the weight wasn't distributed evenly, so then I attached two command hooks to either side. So you have options here to attach ribbon, tulle, burlap, and even hang maybe like kind of in an upside down V shape and loop it over your door. The possibilities are endless. I hope you enjoyed this DIY. I love the way the glittery sparkles of the snowflake shine when you kind of come up to the door, but I also like that it's a little bit different, not your typical round wreath. I've always had my round wreath, and I thought this was just fun and different. I hope you enjoyed this DIY, and thank you so much for stopping by. I look forward to sharing more with you very soon. Take care, everyone. Bye.